What is the Azure Traffic Manager? How do you use it? And of course, why would you want to? I'm going to tell you all about it coming up now. Hello, everybody. My name is Adam Gordon, an edutainer here at ITProTV, back with another fun-filled and exciting conversation as we continue examining what are Azure services. We're going to take on the Azure Traffic Manager in this episode, and we're going to look at this as we always do, asking three questions that help us to truly understand what the service or feature is. What is the Azure Traffic Manager? Why would you want to use it? What value does it provide to you and your organization? And of course, always fun, always exciting, how do we actually put this thing to work for us? And how do we make sure it's going to work the right way? When we think about what the Azure Traffic Manager is, we want to really think about not only the idea of traffic management, but the simplicity that we always take for granted of things just being there when we ask for them and ultimately we want to use them. And those things are typically services and data. We traditionally will refer to that in our diagrams over here as a web app service that Azure can provide, some sort of web page or some sort of thing that we can connect to over the web and use. Maybe we're Googling, trying to look something up. Maybe we are running some sort of database that we want to be able to access and ask a question against, looking up our customer record or perhaps information about our bank balance while we're standing at an ATM. Any and all of those things will involve some sort of web application or web service today. And what traffic management allows us to do is to be anywhere that we can be connected using an application or some sort of device, a smartphone, a tablet, a desktop, a laptop, it doesn't matter what, just have to be able to point it at the internet, ask a question, where is my resource? Can you please point me to it if I give you the address and tell you where I want to go? And as a result of that, have a device, a service, a functionality that's going to take that request and ensure that it gets to the appropriate place to give us the outcome we're looking for. And this is the simplicity of what traffic management really involves. So when we answer the what is Azure Traffic Manager question, it's really all about making sure that all of the user requests for resources that we want to get to, regardless of where they're located, over in the west or over in the east data center, or anywhere in between in the Azure fabric, that these web application services, these web apps that can be accessible and used, that we can get to them. And if one were to fail for some reason, one was unavailable, it's no longer there, we can redirect our traffic down and make it available somewhere else seamlessly for the end user, ensuring there's no disruption or interruption of their ability to consume a service. Because after all, if you think about it, when we request our bank balance or want to see that latest information item or the latest sale, right, on Amazon, we don't want to wait. We want that information to be available to us. And why should we wait? We should have the ability to be able to immediately provide that from somewhere else. And that's what Traffic Manager does for us. So if we add a couple of elements to our design here, and we put this question mark in that represents that question we want to ask. And that question is, in this case, where can I find ITPro.tv? I want to see that website. I want to be able to see that resource. Maybe I'm down here on my smartphone waiting for it to load so I can watch one of my exciting episodes around how you use and implement the Traffic Manager from our library. Well, when I do that, I'm going to send that request out and it's going to go into the Azure Traffic Manager sitting out there waiting for these requests. And that Traffic Manager has been told exactly what it needs to know. Where should that request go? Should it go to Azure West? Should it go to Azure East in our data center fabric where we have an application gateway and a firewall waiting to accept it, applying rules and business logic to it, and then allowing us to serve up that web page, provide me my ITProTV episode on how to use Traffic Manager from the appropriate Azure web app service. In this case, a content delivery network that would stream that video content for me. And so what I would do is just have a line that would come out of here and would go across to either one of these, right? And we would wind up being able to see that traffic flowing in, and we would label one of these data center areas our primary Traffic Manager profile. We'll see how that's done as we take a look at how we implement Traffic Manager in just a few minutes. And we would label another one of these our secondary or our failover Traffic Manager profile, always available, always on, always monitoring, but only serving up from our secondary or failover environment if our primary were to become unavailable. And then we would simply prioritize using our secondary, streaming that content back out and never missing a beat. And so when we look at what Traffic Manager involves, it involves our ability to understand smartly and in real time how to move traffic to ensure availability, globally at scale, by the way. When we think about why we'd want to use Azure Traffic Manager, reality is we all have a need to ensure that the application services that our businesses provide, that our users, our customers are consuming, that those are always on, they are always available. In today's modern interconnected world, we don't have the ability, nor the luxury, or the capability to explain to people why we can't service those needs in real time for them. They expect that our web app will just always be there. That's what they're paying us for. That's what they have trust in us as providers to do. And you have to service that need and step up and make sure that you can take care of your customers. ITProTV does that. Our content is available 24/7, 365, always on, always available to you when you want to see it. The way we do that is by leveraging this kind of infrastructure. So making sure we understand the value and the value proposition of why is because we want to ensure always on availability, always on content, on demand for users whenever they want to see it. Let's turn our attention to how we actually make this work. I want to take you on a tour and show you how to implement the Azure Traffic Manager. We're going to take a look at that right now. Hello, everybody. Let's actually jump on in. Let's take a look at how we actually get Traffic Manager configured. I've gone ahead and built out two resource groups, one called Traffic Manager, the other called Traffic Manager West. We can see them right down here. And I've already taken the liberty of configuring a web application that will run in each, providing our web application service, essentially the web page that we want to see. And I've gone ahead and configured the Traffic Manager profile, as well as the two endpoints that we need in order to test our theory about whether we can route our traffic successfully, even if one of our two endpoints is no longer available. I'm going to walk you back through how I did all that. We'll do a quick demonstration to show you that the endpoint is currently up, and when we fail it over, how it still provides capabilities and gives us access to our web content without missing a beat. So let's go ahead and let's just take a look at what I did. I'm in the Traffic Manager, about to go in to the Traffic Manager resource group, the first of the two that I've built out. And what we'll see over here is that I have a web application, the app service called East Web. It's just a very simple web app that provides a default web page, nothing fancy. I've got the backend monitoring and the app service plan capabilities all associated with it. We created that using a separate wizard. You'll see the same thing as there in the other Traffic Manager resource group. It's simply labeled West as opposed to East Web. And then below that, highlighted, is our Traffic Manager profile. I've gone ahead and created that separately by using the add capability in the resource group, going to the marketplace and searching for Traffic Manager. And I find the Traffic Manager profile element. I've chosen to create that, and I want to take you in and show you what goes on as we do that. So we're going to highlight this. We're just going to simply click to select it. And when I do that, I've got the Traffic Manager profile set up. And we've got our settings area. I'm on the traffic view. We get to see some overview material. And when I look at endpoints, I see those two endpoints that are over there on the right, labeled endpoint east and endpoint west. Notice both are enabled. Notice the monitor status for both is set to online. Now, what I want to do before we delve into this is just go back here one step. I'm going to go back to my resource groups. I'm going to go to my Traffic Manager West resource group, and I'm going to show you what it looks like to create that Traffic Manager profile. We're going to go browse, going to go and start typing in Traffic Manager, and not even get that far. And you'll see as I type traffic, I get Traffic Manager profile. This is the element, the object that I want to create. We simply use our create option directly from the interface here. And we're given a very simple 5 or 6 question form we have to fill out. We do need to provide a unique name within the namespace, trafficmanager.net. That is globally across the entire Azure Fabric, anywhere in the world. That name in front of trafficmanager.net has to be unique. So we want to make sure that that is the case. We put in a unique name, whatever it will be. We get a green check that will make sure that it is unique. We choose our routing method. There are several options there. Performance is the default. Let's just put in a name there to get that to be unique. We do see our green check. we look at our routing methods, and we could see we have performance, weighted, priority, geographic, subnet. The details around all this and how you would understand more about this are something you can take a look at over at ITProTV if you want to learn more about it with me. Come over, hang out with me, and I walk you through how to do all this in depth and explain in more detail what these different routing methods may imply. But for now, we just went ahead and chose priority, which is what I talked about at the light board, as we talked about our primary and perhaps our secondary or failover area that we would use. So that's what our priority method would be. We have our subscription. We have our resource group. We specify either a default name or create a new one, and we see the resource group location. So I've done all this. I've clicked the create button down below here. It takes about a minute. And then we do have our traffic manager profile, which we're working with right now, and we're going to go back to. I've created the web app separately. We're not worried about how to do that right now. But again, I certainly give you that level of detail when I go through this in more than one of my courses over at ITProTV. And you could certainly watch me do it there if you would like. When we come back over here and we choose our endpoints from our traffic manager profile, we have to add them in because our endpoints represent where we are going to provide the service that we actually want to potentially load balance and have the traffic manager interact with and provide access to. The Azure East and Azure West blocks on the right-hand side of the light board, as I was explaining how this would all work, where our web application firewall and our web app service would be located. That's the web application that I've created that you saw at the heart of the resource group. And I've simply added in the endpoints here, labeling one East and West, associating each of my web applications with one of them. And I've made sure they're both online and enabled. And I use the add button right there to do that. When I do that, I do have to provide answers to, again, some relatively basic questions here. What type of Azure endpoint or what type of endpoint am I adding? I'm using an Azure endpoint. I give it a unique name. I specify the target resource type. Is it a cloud service, an app service, things like that. Then the target resource, I choose the appropriate resource based on the resource type. I specify a priority. That's that rating or ranking that I suggested that would let me designate the primary versus the secondary or failover instance. In our example, we're using a rating, a primary rating of one, a secondary rating of two. So I have two endpoints and I've given each one of them a rating or priority scale. And then I simply click add at the bottom. And when I do that, they're both created, both brought online, and you could see the priority rating one and two is there respectively. What that tells us is that endpoint East is our primary endpoint, providing access to our web application backend. And endpoint West is our secondary or failover instance. Now, the other thing that I've done is gone to the overview element right here at the top. And on the summary area, I've grabbed the DNS name that you see right there, which is how I can access the traffic manager. That is essentially the front end publicly available interface that I want to use. I've copied that just by clicking copy to the keyboard, copy to the clipboard, excuse me, as I just did. And I've gone ahead and I've pasted that, as you can see right here, into a web browser. And I've brought that up and I'm looking at my traffic manager and I can see the web page that my web app is providing, just this generic web page, and it's up and running. And if I hit refresh, it stays there, it's good, everything is great. In order to test the failover, what I have to do is go into my endpoints. Let's go back down here. And I have to go to the primary endpoint. I'm going to highlight it, click on it, and I'm going to go in and I'm going to disable it. I'm going to change that enabled status to disabled and save that status change. That is going to take that offline. And remember, that was the endpoint that was providing that web page that we just looked at right there. I do see that the status on that has been saved, and therefore it is now offline. It says disabled. And as a result, it's no longer providing me that web page. That status, in other words, we can see has changed. But what should happen immediately is Endpoint West should be available and should step right in and provide continued access to that web page. So what we're going to do is open up a browser, type in our address again, and sure enough, there is our web page, and we can see that it's still available. And as a result, our failover status, our secondary endpoint, has stepped right up, and Traffic Manager simply rerouted our traffic request over there. And without missing a beat, our service stays available, our customers are happy, and you don't have to worry about responding to an incident that could have been avoided by simply deploying this technology and using it smartly. We'll continue to take a look at new, innovative, and interesting, as well as important Azure services for you to be familiar with. That's what the Azure series is all about, and that's the value of spending time with me. You get to find out all about them and get the answers to the what, the how, and of course, the why. I'm going to wish you happy Azuring. I'm going to be back with more episodes, and make sure you keep coming back to check us out here, and also check me out over at ITProTV if you want more in-depth discussions about this or any of the Azure content we always highlight here in our serial. I'll see you soon.